Hello, George.
Hello.
How are you doing?
I'm good, thank you.
First of all, fantastic session. How was that for you?
Yeah, it was really good. Piano was a bit out of tune, and the pad broke, and backing vocals were a bit out. But
apart from that, it was great.
Yeah, it was good.
And how does it feel to sort of perform in front of a crowd at this iconic venue? I mean, Abbey Road, so many famous artists have recorded here. Of course, the Beatles, Bond films have been recorded here, the scores have been recorded here.
Yeah.
So that must make it pretty special, right?
Yeah, I guess. Yeah.
Now, one thing I just need to really quickly clear up is there's another George Barnett out there, and I wanted to check that
absolute pig.
Are you aware of this? Because there's another George who is a model and he plays the drums.
These New Puritans, yeah.
Yeah.
That's confusing. I don't know him. No. No. I know of him, and I really like These New Puritans. Their album Hidden was really, really cool. So, and he's a great drummer. And I think it's him and his brother Jack are both in it.
Yeah,
and
twin brother.
Yeah, it's really cool. I did consider changing it, but I can't be bothered. It's all right.
I was already talking to you about being a twin. I'm an identical twin.
Oh, you really?
I was going to ask you about being a twin. But I won't, actually, now.
No, I'm not a twin. I'm sorry. I'm not the same guy.
Instead, tell us about your first album. So 17 Days, it's out on Monday. Tell us a little bit about that.
Yeah, cool. I didn't know it was out on Monday, but that's cool. Yeah, it's... basically, when I first recorded it about a year and a half ago, I was recording things at home, every instrument at home, and I was releasing one track every 17 days, and that's where the name comes from. And then at the end of it, I chose the best ones and made them into the album, and that's how the album came about.
So what can we expect from it? We had a little taste just now with your great session, which is going to be available for you to watch on the website shortly. Mm. But tell us what fans can expect who haven't obviously seen today.
Well, audible sound for a start. I don't know, a lot of loud bits and quiet bits and rocky bits and poppy bits and funk bits, lots of different bits, but all in a nice shell.
lots to look forward to.
Yeah.
What about touring? Are you going to be doing some gigs on the road?
So? Yeah, in a bit, in a few months down the line. Yeah, we're just planning them now. So.
Around the UK, or are you going
to
go abroad?
Yeah, around the UK, not abroad yet. Around the UK.
Now, when I was doing a bit of research on you, I read that you've been into music since the age of three.
Yeah.
So how did that start? What did you pick up first? Because you play all sorts of different instruments.
Yeah.
We saw you on the piano earlier. Mm. Did you start with the piano or?
Yeah, I actually did. I forgot until last week that it was piano. I used to always say it was drums, but it was actually piano. My mum used to run a nursery school, and the teacher who came round... she wasn't really a teacher, she used to just play nursery rhymes and stuff, but she helped me play some tunes when I was three, some banging tunes.
Wow.
Impressive. No, but yeah, and then I picked up drums around four, so, banging on stuff and just progressed.
And in 2008, you won the Drummer of the Year, Young Drummer of the Year.
Yeah.
That must have been an amazing feeling.
Yeah, it was. It was really good. Because up until that point, I'd only ever wanted to be a drummer, really. And all through until 2009, 2010, really, when I was, 16 or something, then I started. I'd always written songs, but I had never put them out or tried to record them. And I started recording at home then.
So what was the sort of catalyst? Why did you, want to try your hand at other things then?
Sick of the drummer jokes. No, not really. I don't know. I just thought. I just gave it a try because I liked the songs and I liked hearing the recorded songs as opposed to just hearing them in my head all the time. Yeah.
And where did the name for your band come from?
The Ninth Wave?
Yeah.
That's a painting. And if you search it, you'll find it.
Can you tell us a little bit about that? Save us searching?
No. it's an amazing painting of a ship that's just gone down. And there's a sunset, and there's some guys just clinging to the flotsam and jetsam. It's really cool.
Oh, sounds nice. We'll have to have a look at that.
Yeah.
And so, what do you make of Abbey Road? Is this the first time you've been here? These studios, I mean, they're pretty fantastic, aren't they?
Yeah, I've seen photos, but the real thing. It's great.
And have you done the we've got the bandmates here as well.
The bandmates. Yeah.
Just introduce them for to us.
Oh, cool.
If you can.
Well,
I'm
this.
Not sure if you can sweep round. The
can you do that, Finn there. There. Oh, I'll just say your name so you just raise your hand like a caveman. Finn. He's done it. Rob. He plays bass. Chris is the drummer, and he's around the back. He doesn't get any drummer jokes from us, though, because we're not like that.
And Chris joined you on the piano earlier as well.
Yeah, so Chris played... We all play a lot of different things, actually, which is really good.
Very talented bunch of guys.
Yeah.
And have you done the, walking across the zebra crossing?
No,
have you
not
done
yet.
That?
No. I don't know if we will or not. It's a bit... Loads of people do it.
Yeah?
A bit touristy. A bit clichéd. Well, I might do it.
It's something to have on the
yeah.
You know, on your
my mum would like it.
Yeah. Well, speaking of friends and family, I mean they must be pretty thrilled that it's all going really well for you guys
yeah.
at the moment.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, yeah. My mum's really supportive. She's been supportive since the start, and my dad as well. Yeah.
But what do you make of the music industry at the moment? We just had the Brits. What do you listen to? What's on your iPod?
Oh, well. I like listening to a lot of hip-hop lately and sort of Frank Ocean I really like at the moment, Kendrick Lamar, Kanye West, that sort of stuff.
Father-to-be soon, isn't he?
That's true, yeah. Yeah, that's going to be weird.
Do you follow the
not,
sort of...
Not that side of it as much. I really like him. I think he's a really amazing artist. But his, you know, celebrity thing is all a bit...
So are you a fan of Jay-Z as well? All that.
Yeah,
all that.
That's cool as well. And Justin Timberlake as well. We're all fans
of
Justin.
Out.
Yeah, coming out 2020, is it
Trouser
called?
Snake? That's what they call him. It's not me, so what's next for you guys? As you say, you've got a tour coming up. Obviously, you're looking forward to releasing your new album, so it's all go. But have you got the next sort of 12 months, couple of years planned out?
More videos, and also I'm recording right now for more stuff as well. There'll be an album out next year, and it'll be better than this one, so... Yeah.
Well, listen, thank you very much for talking to us.
Thank you.
And good luck with the album. It was
thank
a
you.
Fantastic session today.
Thanks a lot.
Don't worry about all the little bits you say went wrong. Nothing went wrong. It's fine. It's fine.
Thank you for tolerating.
That's all right. And good luck with everything.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.